Hey everybody, Scott Spreitzer here, DocSports.com. Welcome to the update for Tuesday, July 21st, 2020. Got a free early Tuesday morning Korean baseball play coming up on this report. Before we get to that, a real quick note, if you've yet to become a member over at DocSports.com and just want to give it a trial run, it's a pretty easy thing to do. You click on that link below the video and get set up for a free $60 account. You can use those free 60 bucks on any of my daily packages or anybody else on the roster over at DocSports.com. Again, get started. Just click on that link below the video if you want to give DocSports.com a trial run. First, I want to answer a couple of the questions. Yeah, I got a couple of the direct tweets from some of you who watch on almost a daily basis with these free videos. And just a quick answer about NASCAR. There will be Cup Series action on Thursday. My plays will be available Thursday morning, but you can grab that package right now. And of course, we wait till the morning of the race to release those. Want to make sure everything's going well with drivers, teams, all that kind of good stuff. But yeah, we did cash on Sunday. We had a sweep with our premium picks. And that brings us now to 6-1 with our last four races, 37-16, just a shade under 70% with the last 53 NASCAR plays over at DocSports.com. Didn't get the free pick win here, but again, just a real nice run for those who've jumped on board with those premium picks, and I surely appreciate those who have done so thus far. Baseball starts Thursday, and we found out over the last week or so that some books are gonna no longer allow you to list starting pitchers. Some books will still allow you to list starting pitchers for now. We've heard, in fact, in Nevada that William Hill, Caesars, a couple of those books are still going to allow it for now, as of Monday afternoon. And then there'll be some books who don't. South Point's going to call it action. Westgate's going to call it action. You won't be able to name starting pitchers in Major League Baseball. Listen, here's the bottom line. We're going to know for the most part who's going each and every day. Once in a great while, it might affect us. So let's not make too much out of it. Yeah, I'm a guy who's a traditional baseball bettor going way back to the early and mid 90s. And it's a situation where I'd rather list pitchers in a look for those books that do, but again, I don't think it's going to affect us a whole lot when we get things underway. And we'll know those rotations, and of course, they'll be having their probable pitchers out days in advance like normal. So not too worried about it there. As far as what's going on for Thursday's opening day, you know about the two games. We are in action in one of those two games, and you can jump on board, check out my baseball package over at DocSports.com. The plays, of course, start on Thursday, the games, I should say, the season. So looking forward to baseball, looking forward to NBA and NHL. Real good news if you're watching the Dodger game over the weekend. You saw they posted on and even talked about a little bit that over 14,000 COVID tests among baseball players and personnel, the last 14,400 plus, they only had six positives. On Monday, we saw the NBA post that they've had about 350 tests of players inside the bubble since July 13th over the last week. Zero positives. The NHL, over 2,600 COVID tests over the last week. Two positives. All great news, obviously, from a sporting perspective and in general perspective overall. So good to see. It looks like we're going to be playing ball in a lot of sports coming up over the next week. So can't wait. We're ready to go. But anyway, I want to get to what's going on for us real quick. KBO premium total that I got going for Tuesday morning is available up until about 12:45 a.m. Eastern on Tuesday morning. You can get that over at DocSports.com. And of course, I will be in action in soccer on Tuesday at 11:30 Eastern. KBO post at 3:30 p.m. Eastern each and every day for the next day's game. So check that out also. All right, let's get to our free pick for Tuesday's card. Again, these games go at 5:30 a.m. Eastern, 2:30 a.m. Pacific. First half total for me here. I've got another one over at DocSports.com, a premium first half total, but we got one here. It's the game one clash between Kia and Hanwha, and you look at the pitching matchup and you're thinking there's going to be minimal scoring, at least on paper. It should translate onto the field. First of all, you got Drew Gagneau going for Kia. He's had a terrific season. I was jotting down in his last seven starts. His team, not just him, but his team has given up a grand total of 23 runs in his last seven starts. On the flip side, you got Kim going for Hanwha, and Bumsoo Kim has allowed, or when he starts his last five games, Hanwha has allowed a grand total of just 15 runs in his starts. Here's the thing. We know that Kia's seventh in scoring in the league on average. They've only scored straight runs in their last three games. We know Hanwha is terrible at the plate, scoring, team batting average, OBP, all that stuff. But here's what we're going to do. We're going to recommend a play under 4.5 in the first half of the game, first five-inning play. First five innings, under 4.5 runs between Hanwha and Kia. I just don't want to mess with those bullpens late in the game. So under 4.5, first five innings is our free pick. Don't forget about our free first half total we got going on right now over at DocSports.com, available till 12:45 a.m. Eastern Time. I'm Scott Spreitzer, DocSports.com. If you like these videos, click on that thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe. Do appreciate those who have done so thus far. Let's put them in the win column on Tuesday, right back here Tuesday evening between 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. Eastern Time.